in the name of Jesus. Amen. God said he will have mercy. He said he will have mercy. He will have mercy. So it doesn't matter whether the person is a troublemaker or not. We remember Apostle Paul, when he was Saul, he was a terrorist, killing and beheading innocent Christians. The same Apostle Paul later became one of the greatest apostles. So it doesn't matter whether the person is a professional prostitute or a harlot, Ashewo. We remember Rahab, the harlot that saved the two spies. Yeah, that went to the city of Jericho in the book of Joshua 6:25. And we know that Jesus Christ came through that lineage. That's about God mercy. God mercy. And do we also remember this prostitute that was brought to Jesus Christ? And Jesus, in the book of John, John 8, and Jesus said, whoever among you that have not committed anything should cast the first stone. It doesn't matter whether the person has made several marital mistakes or not. It doesn't matter what has gone wrong in our marital journey. God said, I will have mercy. We remember the Samaritan woman, by the way, in the book of John 4. Jesus said to her, said, go and call your husband and come back. And she said, husband care? No husband though. And Jesus said to her that, woman, you are not lying, you have said the truth, you are telling the truth. And that woman was the first lady evangelist in the New Testament. Amen. So whether the person is persistent offender or a career criminal, God said, I will have mercy. Whether the person is a thief or not, we remember the thief with Jesus Christ on the cross of Calvary. Jesus said to that thief, said, today, yes, you shall be with me in my kingdom. And we know that that thief entered into that kingdom even before the apostles. Amen. So it doesn't matter whether we have a dead situation on ground or not. We remember Lazarus, who had been dead and sinking. And Lazarus came back to life. So whatever situation that had become dead in our life, by the power in the blood of Jesus Christ, they shall come back to life in the name of Jesus. We also remember the valley of dry bones. God said to his servant, he said, these dry bones will live again. He said, prophesy. He said, speak to them. And by the power in the blood of Jesus Christ, I speak this day that every situation that become dead in our life, they will live again. In the name of Jesus. By the power and the anointing upon our daddy Gio, upon our pastors in this church, every situation that look like dry bones, they will come back to life. In the name of Jesus.